All right, let's look at a short little exercise here on calculating gross profit margin. We have a company here, a very large company, Johnson & Johnson, which is reporting their figures. Notice this is in millions, so we have to add a lot of zeros to each of these figures. But that really is not going to change anything for what we're doing. And we're given some information. Some income statement information about inventory that has been sold. All right. And so, you know, sales revenue is an account. Cost of goods sold is an account. But we're being asked for gross profit margin. And really the only way that we can calculate gross profit margin is to calculate simply gross profit. So real quickly, I want to just say they've got this sales to customers here. Okay, just so we're all on the same page, let's make sure we understand this is sales revenue. Okay, and that cost of product sold is cost of goods sold. Okay. Kind of do that like so. All right. And then I'm also going to put right down here, I'm going to put gross profit. All right. So all we have to do here, this is a type of analysis called vertical analysis. So for 2017, I merely have to take 76,450 and I'm going to subtract the cost of goods sold, 25,354. And that's going to give me 51,096. And while we're at it, I'm going to just do that across the board real quick. 71,890 revenue for 2016 minus cost of goods sold of 21,685. That gives us 50,205. All right. And then we're going to do the exact same thing for 2015, so 70,074 minus cost of goods sold of 21,536 equals 48,538. All right. So the formula for gross profit margin is simply gross profit divided by sales revenue. All right. So if that's true, then all we have to do is come across here and take our gross profit figure and divide it by the sales. And let's see, round your answers to one decimal place. So we have 66.8% for our first answer. So you may wonder, you know, why would you do this? If you've got gross profit, you're fine. Well, we want to make sure in business, we kind of want to make sure that if we have increasing sales, that our sales are increasing at least as quickly as the cost of what we're selling is going up. Or if we have decreasing sales, we can look at that too. So 2017 is the first year that we did, and that was the year with the highest sales. So I'll be curious to see what these percentages are for 2016 and 2015. Now, 66.8% is a very, very high gross profit margin. So we're going to be in pretty good shape, I think, on these regardless. But if these other numbers end up being bigger, and I don't think they will be, that could mean that we're selling more, but the cost of what we're selling is also going up. So let's just see what we have here. 2016, our gross profit was $5,205. Let me move this calculator down just a bit. Divided by 71,890. 69.8%. Okay. And then let's see here. All right. And then for 2015, we have a gross profit of 48,538 divided by sales revenue of 7,704. And that gives us 68.6%. All right. So if we were going to look at this strictly from a sales revenue versus cost of goods sold percentage, we would say that we're doing our best in 2016, our second best in 2015, and our worst in 2017. And yet we had the highest level of sales revenue in 2017 and the highest level of gross profit. But as a percentage, and again, all of these percentages are good here, but this is something that can sometimes happen in a competitive marketplace. Sometimes in order to get additional market share, we have to we raise our prices as little as we can possibly get away with. And so, yes, we got higher sales, noticeably higher sales in 2017, but it did cost us some of our margin. Okay. And of course, we've got all of our operating expenses at a minimum that have to be subtracted out of this figure. And so as sales revenue goes up, oftentimes a lot of those operating expenses might go up with them. It just depends on the business. All right. So the calculation for these items is very, very simple. There's really not much to it at all. But understanding the story behind these percentages will actually help you advance your career much, much more so.